One last time. These are small, but the ones out there are far away.
Now, we're going to have a little elocution lesson.
Drink!
Now, Father, you can't be saying that all the time when the bishops come here.
Fake!
No, you can't say that either.
Girls!
Look, Father, just let's go back to drink for the moment.
Drink!
Right, now, I want you to have a look at this. Have a go at the first one here.
That. Drink!
No, no, no.
That. Drink!
Now, come on, Father, concentrate.
That. Drink! That
drink,
that
drink,
that
drink,
that
drink,
that
drink,
that
drink,
that drink.
Now come on now, Father, I know you can do it.
There'll be a little drink in it for you if you do it.
Drink?
Yes, I promise. Now come on, try again.
That drink.
Come on now, Father, you almost had it.
That that
great,
that
brilliant, Father. Let's keep it going here on the next one. That one.
Drink!
Did we disturb you, Father Hackett?
Ice biscuits!
What? How dare you speak to His Grace like that? Apologize immediately!
I'm so, so sorry.
No, I can't. But, oh, just listen, wait a minute, wait a minute. There seems to be a very crude watercolour painting of a man in a bishop's hat.
Really?
Anyway, any idea why July the 19th should be so important?
Would that be the day the Ice Age ended?
No, Dougal. It can't be that precise about the Ice Age.
I look it up in the diary. July 19th. On this day, Galway liberated from Indians. Mm-hmm. And, marathon becomes Snickers. Mm-hmm. Aha, Ted. Ice Age ends.
If I was a sheep, I'd be watching my back right now.
Why?
Because of the beast. They say it's as big as four cats and it's got a retractable leg so as it can leap up at you better. But you know what, Ted? It lights up at night and it's got four ears. Two of them are for listening and the other two are kind of backup ears. And its claws are as big as cups and for some reason it's got a tremendous fear of stamps. Mrs. Doyle was telling me that it's got magnets on its tail so as if you're made out of metal, it can attach itself to you. And instead of a mouth, it's got four arses.
Dougal! It's a legend. It doesn't exist.
Right, Ted. The way the Phantom of the Opera doesn't exist.
The Phantom of the Opera doesn't exist! Look, I'm not going to get into this what does exist and what doesn't exist debate again, OK? But I'm going to have to insist you add those last two examples to the chart.
But, Ted,
Dougal!
You're not going to believe this. Clint Eastwood has been arrested for a crime he didn't. Oh, wait, no, it's a film.
Hello,
I remember that in a moment.
Elvis became famous. Then they forced him into the army. Then he came out. And 10 years later, he came back with a comeback special. Was back. From then until the end of his life, he played in Las Vegas and became once again the king of rock and roll. Ladies and gentlemen, that was The Three Ages of Elvis. Thank you.
I suppose I'll just see if there's anything on the television, so.
What type of a jumper is that, anyway?
Well, basically, it's a...
Father?
Think off!
Father, where did you get the air freshener?
Car!
Oh, God.
Drive the car!
Not the new car. Tell me the truth. Have you been drinking?
Yes!
Tell me from the beginning, where did you drive?
Shops! Drink! Corner! Stopped! Got out! Truck!
Truck?
Two trucks!
Do you remember Sister Sumter?
No.
She was here last year. And then we stayed with her in the convent, back in Kildare. Do you remember it?
I do.
And then you were hit by the car when you went down to the shops for the paper. You must remember all that. And then you won £100 with your lottery card.
You must remember it, Dougal.
Weren't you accidentally arrested for shoplifting? I remember we had to go down to the police station to get you. And the police station went on fire? And you had to be rescued by helicopter?
Do you remember? You can't remember any of that. Huh? The helicopter. When you fell out of the helicopter. Over the zoo. Do you remember the tigers? You don't remember. You were wearing your blue jumper.
Ah, Sister Assumpta, hello there.
Who would he be like, Hitler or one of those mad fellas?
Oh, worse than Hitler. You wouldn't find Hitler playing jungle music at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Now, and what do you say to a cup?
Take off, cup!
He loves his cup of tea.
Take off!
There you go.
Take off! Break! Break! Drink! 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 Drink!
Don't do it, Father. I won't let you do it. I know it hurts, but believe me, you're going to thank me for it.
Shape up, okay? What is it?
I thought I heard someone. Maybe I'm just going crazy. I've been in this damn laundry section so long.
I don't think there's sauce. You take a rest, Father. Father Riley, you go on point.
You okay, Father Deegan? There's no way out. There's just no way out. They're gonna get it.
Damn it, Deegan. Hang on. You don't expect this kind of thing in the priesthood.
I only left the seminary 2 weeks ago. If they find out I'll never get a decent parish, they'll send me off to some bloody kip. What are we gonna do?
Listen, Deacon. I'm gonna make you a promise. One day, you and I, we're gonna be in that new parish of yours, sipping iced tea on the lawn. And this will all be just a memory. Can you hold on to that thought? Can you? Can you do that for me? Good man.
I was messing about with one of these bras and a strap flew back and hit me in the eye. Just in my ankle as well.
Oh, let's get you up.
Oh, it's my stupid fault for messing with the bras. Go on ahead, I'll only slow you down.
Listen, we're a team. We're sticking together. Come on.
Run!
There's the exit.
Thank God.
God, look at all those people.
They definitely see us coming out. Maybe if you actually buy some underpants, then it wouldn't look so strange.
They're women's underpants.
Yeah. Sorry.
Attention, lady shoppers. Gifts for husbands, like pipes and slippers, are now available on the first floor.
Who's got the most boring voice?
What?
Of the lot of us, who's got the most boring voice?
That'll be me, Ted.
Listen,
I have an awful, dreary, monotonous voice.
Yes. Listen.
Ted, were you asking for a dramatic, exciting voice?
No, he said boring. He wanted a boring voice.
In that case, you must excuse me for my impetuous interruption.
Listen, this is what we're going to do. What's going on?
I think Ted has a plan.
No, I mean in general.
Oh. I'm trying to find our way out of the laundry section.
Ladies and gentlemen, could you please bring your purchases to the checkout as the store is about to close? Hurry up. Come on. Hurry up, will you?
Not that way, for feck's sake. The other way.